Make things you want to make and not what you think other people want to see. We just went out to a bunch of networks. We actually said, like, here's the season, here's the characters, here's the arcs, and here's the series arc. So we actually pitched it knowing how the series ends, which is interesting because most networks, you know, heard the whole pitch, but HBO Max, they were like, we don't need to know how it ends. So it's so funny. It ended up at HBO Max, and they're one of the only places who doesn't know how it ends. Everybody pitches differently. Some people sit there, read a piece of paper and read their document, which I think is totally makes sense. And then other people fully don't look at anything or just like pitching and connecting with everybody who they're pitching to. And some people are really scripted. Some people are totally loose. I think we kind of are maybe somewhere in between where we know everything that we're trying to say. But we try to keep it really like lively in a performance because it is a performance, you know, the pitch. Susanna Makos, who we pitched to, was really like, just while we were pitching it, she just so obviously was like, I get it. I love it. I need it. Let's do this. And so it was really, you know, we kind of went with the momentum and the excitement because when you end up making a show with people who don't totally get it or trying to like, you know, adjust your vision here and there, like, you know, it's not necessarily always bad, but when you get somebody who you know from like, when you know you're like on the same page with from the first moment, it really is easier in every way. That moment where the helicopter comes down, we only did that twice. And the second take is the entire take is what's in the cut. Because the plane really was actively coming in and all of that. So I had to like time it so the dialogue would start so that by the time she says, well, I'm not comfortable getting in that, well, you're not, is when it was scripted for it to land. And the first time it was so off and I was like, oh God, this is going to be a nightmare. We're going to be here all day. And it was a really tough day. But then the second take, I was like, okay, based on how much I absolutely biffed it on that first take, I was like, okay. And start. And then the scene was like, literally, I couldn't have dreamed the timing of the helicopter better. I applied to film school at NYU and didn't get in. Like, there's so many things that like I tried and it didn't work. So I kept doing other stuff. I would like, you know, I would audition for to be on Harold teams at UCB, didn't get on any of those. So I just kind of took all the no's and kind of just let it continue to reroute me until I really just like found people who I enjoyed collaborating with and laughing with and writing with and people who I was most excited to be around. And then we started making stuff. And I would just say, like, go with your gut and don't do things that you feel you need to do out of obligation unless that obligation is paying your bills. I learned how to break story from being in the Broad Cities writer's room, having no like education. And I actually think that was one of the reasons that the show I think really resonates with people is that it doesn't feel like it's anything at the time. It didn't feel like really anything else. And I think it's because we didn't know what we were doing. And that was good in a way, basically just the idea of like breaking stories. What are all the different scenes in a story? And how does the first act, second act, third act affect it's each other and how do you make sure that the third act feels like it's connecting to the first act and how have these characters changed and what is their, you know, lowest point and how are they going to use things they learn to overcome whatever, like all those things, like you want to, in some ways there's like structure that is important because like it's basic human storytelling, but there's also ways to subvert that I think in really interesting ways that can just come from like accidental subversion or intentional subversion. And I guess like, to me, like no story works without a really, really solid structure and without breaking. And like, sometimes you'll like, you'll break it and you'll be like, does this make sense? And it's like, it kind of doesn't work. If you don't know why, we got to go re-break it and figure it out. And actually these scenes can go and this act is way too long. How can you condense it? Whatever it is. But like the only way you can really learn any of that stuff is just by doing it. Like I was saying, I've made like so many videos, like I made like 200 videos before I did one moment of television, right? But had I not done all of that work before I did TV, I would have shown up and absolutely not known what I was doing, would have absolutely freaked out, would have been like, oh my God, if I'm doing two people on one side of the room and the other person on the other side, when I split eye lines on this side, which shoulder do I go over when I'm turning around? Like something like that. Like you don't want to necessarily be figuring out when you're directing for the first time on TV. You know, I think there's nothing like doing it yourself, fully DIY, because that is the way that you learn. And also you learn how you want to tell stories. But had I not like practiced for years and years and years, I don't think I would have had the same success I've had.